Hi friends, welcome to Gurav YouTube channel. This channel is about education and technological purposes. If you're not subscribed, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. One byte is equal to how many bits?
Yes.
1 0 byte is equal to
1024
bits. 1 word is equal to
32.
It depends on the computer version. 32 bit version or 64 bit version. Depending on that, we can see that considering the problem. Okay. What do you mean by binary digits? Binary number representation, combination of a binary digits. We call it as a binary number. Okay. Let's say inside the computer. How exactly the computer will work? We are now discussing inside the computer, right? First of all, go through the diagram. Just like I mentioned, it is a blur diagram. There is a CPU part. First part is a CPU. Second part is a primary memory. Is it visible to you all? Primary memory. Middle one, input-output controller. Secondary memory. Mouse, keyboard, monitor, printer, scanner. Next is a network, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. In the CPU, which are the parts? Arithmetic and logic units, ALU. Next is the control unit, registers. In the primary memory, random access memory, represent the RAM, read only memory, that is a ROM. It is in the primary memory. In the secondary memory, hard disk, DVD, ROM, drive, tape drives, flash memory. Okay, these are the parts. The questions, they may ask the questions like explain the inside of the computer or explain architecture of a computer with single process. How they will frame the question on this topic? Explain the architecture of computer, that's all. Or explain the architecture of computer with a single processor. That will be the question. Okay, now consider here CPU. The brain of the computer is CPU. Central processing unit, right? You can compare the computer, working of the computer with the human also, right? Yes or no? The brain which calculates also, which do the operations, that is nothing but a CPU. Brain of the computer is a CPU. CPU represents central processing unit. Represent a single chip on the computer, right? Which represents a single chip on a computer. Right? You are saying that Intel Einstein processor, I5 processor, dual core, core studio, they are the processor. No, we call them normally as a central processing unit only. That's a unit. Unit represents a part. Clear? Most work is carried by ALU. Right? In the CPU, the most work is carried by ALU. ALU represents arithmetic and logic unit. Fast memory is a primary memory or RAM, right? Considering here the primary memory, right? Memory represents here the storage of the values of say data. That can be stored in a primary memory or that can be stored in a secondary memory. Storage, right? Data to store. That can be done in a primary memory or that can be done in a secondary memory. But fast memory is a primary memory, right? That is nothing but we will call it as a RAM. What is that RAM? Random access memory. Random access memory. Slow memory is nothing but a secondary memory. It's a slow one. It's not a fast compared to the RAM. Clear? Or hard disk or auxiliary storage. What we call it as a secondary memory, we can call it. We can call it as a hard disk also, we can call it as a auxiliary storage. These are some introductions regarding this diagram. Okay? Now we move next. The CPU. Now, who will mention the parts in the CPU? Or say, the architecture of the CPU program, architecture of a computer. Mention the parts. Who will mention the part? One part. in the CPU? In the CPU, which are the parts? AI will say arithmetic logical unit. Next one is control unit. Register. Sit up. Next. Primary memory. In the primary memory, RAM is there. Next. Primary memory. One more component is this. ROM. Read only memory. Sit up. What is the next one? Memory. Hard. Secondary memory. In the secondary memory, hard is then. So many components are there. What are the parts of the hardest? CD, ROM, I think it is. DVD, okay. DVD, ROM. Then, flash memory. Okay, just moving to the hard disk in the secondary memory, hard disk, DVD, ROM, tape drives, flash memory. Right? In the input devices, like it is having a mouse, keyboard, monitor, printer, scanner. There, connectivity, network, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. Now, we will go for the explanation of the CPU. CPU is a central processing unit. We will call it as the brain of the computer. Okay. Here, what is the first point? CPU is a central processing unit, right? But in the computer, where exactly it presents? It is presented as a microprocessor or processor. I told you, Intel i7 is a processor. Clear dual core processor are there. Core to DOI, i7, i5. Right? These are the processors or microprocessors existed in a computer. That would be called as a CPU, central processing unit. Microprocessor or processor is a central processing unit there, which is consisting of a arithmetic logical unit, control unit, some special purpose registers, and a clock. Clock is very important. Perform all arithmetic and logical calculations. CPU, what it will perform? It will perform all arithmetic and logical calculations. What do you mean by arithmetic calculations? Arithmetic calculations, something like multiplication, division, addition, subtraction. This will be considered as an arithmetic calculation. What do you mean by logical calculations? Performing a logical operations like a AND, OR, XOR, XNOR, right? So many logical operations that can be carried in using a logical unit, arithmetic and logical unit. ALU. We will call an ALU as a super calculator, which again performs a Boolean operations like a AND OR. That is nothing but logical operation. Boolean operation represents logical operation. That is nothing but like a AND OR, etc. So this is regarding a arithmetic and logical unit. Now next comes a control unit. You see the diagram there. There is a connection from a CPU to the primary memory, again to the input-output device. So are connected with this, right? There is a control of all the parts associated in the diagram, or say in the computer architecture. All the parts should be controlled and should be coordinated for performing the operation. Is it not? All should be controlled and all should be coordinated with each other to perform particular operation. For the reason, control unit is very important. Sorry. Which is using the signals, right? Control unit is using the signals. The control unit controls the way data is moved between various components. What the control unit will do, which will control the way data is moved between the various components, means here, where the data is moving from the CPU to the primary memory. Again, from the primary memory to the input-output devices, right? The movement, control unit will control these all the movements by using the signals. There is not a transfer of the data, there is a transfer of the signals also. Here, from the RAM, we will send the data to the CPU by data buses. What do you call? Data bus. But from the control unit, the signal bus will be transferred to maintain the input output of the RAM. That's a very important point. Moved between the various components. Clock is used for sequencing and synchronizing purpose. What is the use of a clock? Sequencing and synchronization. Synchronization represents, it's like a coordinating. Any work should be carried out, all the members should coordinate with each other. Like any calculation in the computer can be carried by coordinating or by synchronizing all the components. Clock is used for that reason. Okay? Clock is used for the sequencing and synchronizing purposes. CPU uses few high-speed registers to store current instruction and its data. Right? What CPU will use? CPU will use some high-speed registers for the storage of a current instruction and its data. Right? CPU represents for the calculation. No? You need a calculation in a fraction of a second. Right? You don't want to wait for a calculation. In a fraction of a second, you need the output. For the reason, some special registers are used to store the data and the instructions. Clear? PC. What do you mean by PC? Program counter is a one register. Program counter. PC is nothing but program counter is a register which is used. That is used for a store to store the address in a primary memory for the next instruction to be executed. Right? PC will hold which next instruction should be executed. Right? If the processor is executing some amount of a calculation, no? Then what the next instruction should be executed, that is stored in the PC. CPU, what it will do? It will fetch the instruction from the PC, execute. What is the PC? Again, it will take the next instruction. And like the work will be faster. If you will store the instruction in the program counter, CPU will take that, it will execute. It will take that and will execute. Next is program instructions executed using a fetch, decode, execute mechanism. Whatever you are giving the working or say the calculation purposes, that is follows a fetch, decode, execute mechanism. What do you mean by fetch? Taking the instructions or data from the user. Decoding represents converting it into a understandable to the computer. Execute means executing that code for the output purpose, for the result purposes. Right? Instruction is fetched from primary memory using PC, right? I will tell you here. Just I will take one example. You are giving the addition of two number calculation purposes. Addition of two number. Right? Whenever we return the program for the addition of two number, no? You are giving the program also, you are giving the data. You are giving the program also, you are giving the data. From where you are giving? From keyboard, mouse you are giving. Am I right or wrong? From keyboard, mouse you are giving. Then what it will do? Input of the controller will take that and it will give the values to the primary memory. Also, it will be stored in a primary memory. Primary memory is not a permanent one. Whenever we need, we have to take it and execute. From the primary memory, the data will go to the secondary memory. Then the calculations after that. What's your calculation? What's your calculation? Addition of two number. Addition of two number calculation is done here in the CPU. Result will be generated. When the result is generated, the result again comes back here for the input output. And again here for the monitor. Is there monitor? Yes. Monitor. You will get the output here. The output if you want to store permanently. The output, if you want to store permanently, you are using a save button there. Am I right or not? Save. Whenever you will save, whatever the primary content is there, it will be saved to the secondary memory. What is the secondary memory user? Store permanently. Store permanently. Primary will not store. Again, if you want any connections, you can connect to the Wi-Fi network. Analogous to the primary memory and secondary memory, how they will work with each other. I will give you one example.
It will go to offices. Where the files are kept? Cupboard. Files are kept in a cupboard. But where they are working? How they work for people? On the table or not? Files are there in the cupboard. Right? What they will do? If you give any workload, they will go to that cupboard, they will take the proper file, required file, and they will work on the table. After work completes, again they will take the file and they will show in the cupboard only. Am I right or not? That table is a RAM, cupboard is a hard disk. Whenever you want to work, it will be worked in a RAM. But if you want to store it, it will be stored in a secondary memory. RAM is not a problem. If the power goes out, whatever the content in the RAM will be vanishes. That is nothing but random access memory. Right? But if you store enough permanently, you can access it. Right? There's a point here. All activities need synchronization by a clock which generate a pulses at regular intervals. Right? Every month, right? It is depending on the clock pulses, right? Your friend given that in earlier classes that his processor is of 2.1 gigahertz. They are given on 2.2? 2.3 gigahertz of speed. That's a clock pulse generation, right? How much a clock pulse is there in your computer, that much work will be faster. Clear? Fasting, or say speed of your computer is also depend on the clock, right? All activity needs synchronization by the clock which generate the pulses at the regular intervals. CPU cannot execute more than one instruction in one clock pulses, right? For one clock pulse, more than one instruction will not be executed there. Faster the clocks, faster the work. How much a clock is fast, that much work will be faster one. Consider one example. Intel i7 has a clock speed of 3.4 gigahertz. 3.4 gigahertz i7 processor. That is a clock process, right? Next is a multi-cores. To do the parallel working in the computer, multi-cores should be there. Like a dual core, core video, i7, I think. Again, i7 is also having a 3 cores. I think there are 4 cores also. Right? Depending on the course, or say the portion in the processors, it is for the parallel calculation. It will help you for parallel calculations. Multi cores are there. Primary memory. There, it is a primary memory. What